Good morning, students. How are you all? So all are fine. I hope all are fine. Okay, good. There is some small review in the previous class portion, children. Do you remember that portion? What are the things learned that previous class? Very good. Leaf. What is leaf? What are the characteristic features of leaf? Functions of leaf. What are the functions? Primary function and secondary function. And the next one, one more important 5-mark question. What are the parts of leaf? What are the three parts, children? Can you able to say? Yes, leaf piece, petiole and lamina. Yes, very good. The next one, venation. What does mean by venation, children? The arrangement of the veins on that leaf lamina. Region. Vein and veinlet. So they present in the leaf lamina, or that's a leaf blade region, is known as venation. Very good. The next one, two type of venation majorly. What are the two types? Reticulate venation and very good, parallel venation. Am I correct? Parallel venation is mostly they found in monocotyledonous glands. Reticulate venation is mostly they found in dicotyledonous glands. Very good. Then last, finally, we learned that one of the 5-mark question, phyllotaxy. What does mean by phyllotaxy? What are the types of phyllotaxy? Am I correct? So this much of the portions covered. That's the last class. So today's class, we are going to learn about, that's the next topic, leaf type. Okay. So how will you identify the leaf type, children? Okay. So first of all, the pattern of divisions of the leaf. Yeah. The divisions of the leaf. So they present in a different components. Okay. The different components. So that is we are called, that's a leaf type. Mainly based on the number of the segments. So this is the leaf lamina region based on that number of segment based. So this is the common leaf. Okay. So that's a based on the number of the segment based. They are divided into two major type of the leaves, children. One is a simple leaf and another one is compound leaf. Clear? Simple leaf already you know. So this is the simple leaf. Example, so these are the compound leaves. Clear, children? Yes. What does mean by simple leaf? The simple leaf means, so the petioles, so they bears, that's a single lamina. Clear? A single leaf blade region. So the petiole, they bears, that is single lamina, or that is a single. Very good. So that's a single surface area. So that is we are called, that's a name is known as simple leaf. Okay. So in that regions, it may be that's a leaf, or sometimes the incision is present. Incision means cutted area. It sometimes that's a leaf lamina, there is presence in an entirely. Clear? That's a entirely, that is one of this good example of this simple leaf. So that's a mango species. Clear? Yes. Next one, what does mean by compound leaf? Okay. What does mean by compound leaf? These all the types are they comes under in a compound leaf, children. Let us learn one by one. Compound leaf, they are mainly, they are divided into two types. One is pinnately compound leaf and another one is palmately compound leaf. Clear? First of all, what does mean by compound leaf? Clear? The compound leaf means, so this is the main rachis. Okay. So this is the main rachis. This is the one of the central one, vein like one structure is going on now. So that is we are called, that's a main rachis. From this main rachis, that is the opposite direction. So they presence in the many. So that is the, what is the item is presence? Many leaflets are present. Okay. So this type is your call, that's name is known as, what is that? Compound leaf. A compound leaf means, so there they present, so one of the rachis region, one of this rachis region, they present in a more than one lamina surface. Okay, more than one lamina surface. So that is we are called, that's a name is known as leaflets. So first of all, you write about, so what does mean by leaflets? So what does mean by leaflet, children? So that's a main rachis. They bears that very good, more than one leaf lamina. That is the areas which we are called, that's a leaflets. Clear? Then what are the two type of this compound leaf. First one is pinnately compound leaf and another one is commately compound leaf. Okay. So these all the types are they comes under in a pinnately compound leaf. So these all the types are they comes under in a commately compound leaf. Let us learn that's one by one. First one is pinnately compound leaf. Pinnately compound leaf. So they comes under in a four types children. Unipinnate, bipinnate, tripinnate, decompound. Okay, so these are the four subtypes. They comes under in a pinnately compound leaf. This pinnately compound leaf, unipinnate also they comes under in a two types children. One is peripinnate and another one is imperipinnate. Clear? So all of you now itself you already by got this subtypes children. Pinnately compound leaf. This pinnately compound leaf is they comes under in a four types. What are the four types? Unipinnate, bipinnate, tripinnate, decompound. This unipinnate also they comes under in a two subtypes. One is peripinnate and another one is imperipinnate. Okay, then learn this one by one children. First one is what does mean by pinnately compound leaves? So here the pinnately compound leaves means only one main rack is so that one they bearing in a lateral direction. Okay, lateral direction they presents in a many leaflets. They are arranging in an alternate way. Okay, so they are arranging in a alternately in that opposite manner. Okay, so that is we are called that's a pinnately compound leaf. Our just that so you have to be remembering the concept. One main rachis is present, so they are arranging in that's laterally. So in this manner, so here they are arranging in that's alternatively to opposite manner. Okay, so this is the type of this leaf arrangement as we are called as a pinnately compound leaf. Clear? Very good example of the species is tamarind. Okay, so did you see this species? Very good, tamarind. Clear children? Tamarind, acacia. So these are the species that they comes under in a that's a pinnately compound leaf. Let us learn this one by one. First of all, unipinnate. Unipinnate, that also very same concept only repeated here. The rachis is a symbol, so they all have that branches children. They bears that's a leaflets. That's a leaflets are they arranging in a opposite direction in an alternate manner. Clear? Then, so what is that the examples for this unipinnate? Unipinnate, pinnately compound leaf means. So that is they comes under in a rose and neems. So these are the species the examples for unipinnate. Clear? Unipinnate is they comes under in a bipinnate and imperipinnate. How many number of this leaflets are they comes under in a peripinnate and imperipinnate means? So how will you identify these two subtypes means? So that's a leaflet. When the leaflet is even number, so you have to be see this is the tip portion, that's an even number. Okay, that's an even number of the leafletes we are called that's a peripinnate. Okay, that's a good one of the example is tamarind. Suppose when the leaflet is that's a tip region, odd number is present means, so that is we are called that's an imperipinnate. Clear children? What does mean by peripinnate? Very good. So when the leaflet is even number means, so that is the type is called peripinnate. Clear? Odd number is called means, so that is we are called that's imperipinnate. Clear? So that's a good example of peripinnate tamarind is and imperipinnate. So that's a leaf is becomes under in the species names of neem. Okay, Azadirachta indica. Yes. Next one is bipinnate. Bipinnate means. What is that meaning of bipinnate means? Here, the primary rachis, they produce again, this is the secondary rachis. Clear? So, that there only, they present in that is the, they produce in a leaflets. That leaflet is, we are called, that's name is known as pinnate. Okay? So, that's a name is, we are called, that's a pinnate. So, bipinnate means, what's the condition? First primary rachis, this is the area. Then from that one, they produces in a secondary rachis. This secondary rachis produces the leaflet as we are called, that's name is known as pinnate. Clear? So that is we are called, that's a. So this number of this pinnate of the various, okay, the species to species, the number of the spinnerets or they vary. So this type is we are called, that's a, what is the type, children? Bipinnate conditions. Okay, so that's one of the good example is Dilonyx. Clear? Then tripinnate. Tripinnate means how will you identify this one? Just imagine, children, how will you identify? Very good. Primary rachis, that one is they produces in a secondary rachis. The secondary rachis also they produces in a very good tertiary rachis. Okay, so this type of this they are arranging, that's one is we are called, that's what is that? What is that, children? Very good. So that is the tripinnate. Clear? So first primary rachis and secondary rachis follow to they produces in a tertiary rachis. Okay. So this type is we are called, that's a tripinnate condition. So that's a good example of the species is Moringa. Clear? So this is a drumstick. Very good. So that plant is the examples for tripinnate. The next one is decombod. Decombod means, so here the rachis is branch, that's a leaflets. Okay, the branch for the leaflet in it several times. This is a leaflet, children. So there is they presents in a branch. They produces in a several times. So that is we are called, that's name is known as decombod. That's very good example of this. That is carota. What is that common name of that is carota? Already we learned it's taproot modification. Very good, carrot. Okay, the next one is coriander. So these are the good species. They are comes under in a which type of compound leaf? Pinnate leaf, compound leaf, the subtype is they comes under in a decombod. Understood, children? Yes. Next one is palmate leaf, compound leaf. Clear? First one is over, pinnate leaf, compound leaf. Next one is palmate leaf, compound leaves. So this rows. So these are the diagrams, the representation of palmate leaf, compound leaf. Clear? But first of all, what does mean by palmate leaf, compound leaf means? So here, the petioles, they bears itself one or more leaflets. So that one is they presents in a one radiation. Okay, one radiation. So that one is they presents in one of the common point. They produces in a finger-like projections. Okay, one of the stalk or one of the petiole area. So there they bears that's a one or more leaflets. So that one is they arises from a one common point, they produces in a common finger-like projections. Okay, that's one of the finger-like projection is going on. So from that is a finally we are looking in a palm-like structures. Okay, so that is we are called, that's a palmate leaf, compound leaf. These palmate leaf, compound leaf also they comes under in a five types, right? Unifoliate, bifoliate, trifoliate, quadrifoliate, multifoliate. Clear? But depends upon that's a leaflet based only they are identified, they are clarified this, they are given this type names. Understood? But first of all, unifoliate means, so that's a single leaflets. All of you see, look at this diagram. Single leaflet, they presents in the petiole. That is said to be a, what is that name? Unifoliate. Clear? But the leaflet, that's a petiole, they presents in a single leaflet. So that is we are called, that's a unifoliate. Clear? So this is one of the good example of the species is citrus species. Okay? So that's one of the good example of the species is citrus species. Bifoliate. So please try to tell, children. Try to tell this answer. Bifoliate. How will you identify? Very good. The petiole region. Good. Very good. That's a petiole region. They presence in a two leaflets. Am I correct? The two leaflets presence means. So that is we are called as a bifoliate. Understood? So that is the presence in a Dioscorea, Diphyllia. Okay, Dioscorea, Diphyllia. But two leaflets they arise in a petioles regions means. So that is we are called, that's what is the name, children? Bifoliate. Trifoliate means, just you have to be make it this answer, children. Just make it in a one by one. Very good. Trifoliate. How will you presence? Single petiole, they presence in a three leaflets. Okay, one single petiole, so they presence in a three means so that is you are called a trifoliate. Am I correct? Yes. So there, that's an example of the species Trifoliatus Utaprid. That's a binomial name is Aegil Marmelas. Okay. Then clover, that's a trifolium. So these are the two species examples for trifoliate leaves. The next one is podding foliate. What is the meaning of pod? Four. Very good. For how many leaf tips are they present in a single petiole? Very good. The single petiole, they are present in a four leaflets. Understood? Now one single common petiole, they are present in a four petioles, children. Sorry, four leaflets, children. So that is we are called, that's name is known as quadrifolia. So that is the good example is Paris quadrifolia and Marsilia. That's one of this. Very good examples for that Marsilia, familiar that one. Okay. Yes. The last, finally, multifoliate are digitate. Okay. Multifoliate are digitate. What is that meaning of multifoliate? Can you imagine that one? Very good. Single petiole, their presence in a more than, very good, more than five. So more than five, or that is five or more than four. Okay, so that is the leaf lettuce presence means, so that is we are called, that's name is known as multifoliate. Finally, so this one is, they just like a fingers like structures. Okay, this is fingers like structures. So just they appear in the palm like leaf like structures only, they presence in the petiole part. Okay, so that is the leaf type which we are called, that's name is known as multifoliate. Understood, children? We tell that type is digitate. Clear? Yes. Good. Now the example is Bambax sibilla. Okay. Cotton tree plants. So we are telling in these conditions. Understood, children? So these are the leaf type. We learned that's a permeately compound leaf types and pinnately compound leaves. Understood, children? What is that leaf type? What does mean by leaf type? Based on the number of the segments, okay, that's a leaf that's based, they are divided into mainly two types, children, simple leaf and compound leaf. This compound leaf also they divided into mainly two, pinnately compound leaf and palmately compound leaf. Pinnately compound leaf is they comes under these other types, palmately leaves also they comes under these other types. Understood, ma? Yes. Next one is we are going to learn about that some modifications of leaf. What is the major functions of leaf, children? What is the major functions of leaf? Very good. Photosynthesis. Am I correct? So that's a major function. Then apart from this one, okay. So many modifying of the leaves. So that modification based they are doing in a certain special functions. Understood, ma? Major function is the photosynthesis. So they preparing that's a food. Am I correct? Apart from that, the leaves what they perform to modify in a specialized structures. So that they are doing a certain additional functions. Understood? Yes. First of all, we are going to learn about here. That's one of this chart is there given. The leaf modification is there comes under in a lot of the types. Sometimes the leaves are modified in the spines. Sometimes the leaves are modified in the so hook-like structures. Sometimes the leaves are modified into leaf bladder, storaging of the leaves. So that's a pitcher plants, phyllocale, phyllode, floral leaves, tendrils. So these all the modifications are they need to place in the leaf. Clear? Let us learn that's one by one, children. First one is we are going to learn about it's a modification of leaf tendrils. The leaves are they modifying in a tendrils formation. Clear? First of all, certain plants, so that the stem is very weak, stem is present, children. At that time, the special organs, so they are developing in that is a special organ for which purpose means that's a climbing support. Okay, that's they giving in that's a climbing for they giving in an additional support of this particular plant, children. Sometimes that's a whole leaf is they involved to modifying the tendrils, and sometimes that's a partially the leaf part is they modified into tendrils. Clear? So what is the major function? Climbing. Okay, the climbing of the support. So that's the leaves what they modify. So here, which are the examples? Which are the plant species? Which part is they modified into tendrils? Clear? The first one, the entire leaf was modified into one of the species name is Lythrus. Clear? Then the stipules part is they modified into tendrils. So that is the species name is Smilax. Terminal leaflet, already you know that leaflet means what? Okay, that's a terminal leaflet, so that is modified into tendrils, so that is laralia. Okay, the leaf tip region is they modified into tendrils, so that is the species is Chlorica superba. Then apical region of the leaflets, terminal leaflets, so this is the species. Apical leaflets, so that is the species is they modifying its tendrils, Pisum sativa. Clear? Then petiole borders, they modified it to tendrils form, that is the clematis. Okay, so these are the certain plant leaf part they modified into the special adaptations of a tendrils formation. Understood, children? Yes. Next one is leaf hook like structures. For certain the leaves are they modified into a hook like structures. Okay, hook like structures. This also is the same the functioning only, children. The plants they helping to supporting, that's a climbing function. Clear? The climbing of this plant. So that's a major function. So the leaves are they modified into hook like structures. Understood? So first of all, here they are explaining in this one of this species name Begonia unguis cati. Okay, so these leaves, so that's a terminal leaflets, so they modified in a three very sharp and hard like natures of this hook is forming. Okay, so that is a common name is your call, that's name is known as cat's nail. Okay, so that's the name is called as cat's nail. So what is that major use of this hook like structures? Climbing of this tree. Okay, clear, children? Yes. Next one is asparagus, one of the species. Which part is they are modified into hook like structures means the leaf spines regions. Okay, the leaf spines are they modified into hook like structures. Understood, no? So this is the leaf hook like structures modification they present in these two species. The next one is we are going to learn about it. Leaf spines or prickles. Okay, leaf spines or prickles. So certain leaves, so they modify into a spines like structures. Certain leaves, so they produces the leaves, or they modify into prickles. Okay, learn this one. But the first one, so that's a either, so that's the surface or that's the margin of this leaf. So either that is the margin of the leaf or that is the surface of the areas of the leaf. So that one is the adaptation for that they sometimes it's a herbivores animals in xerophytic plants, no? So that one they protect from that that's a type of those animals. So that leaves or they modified into spines like structures or they modifying in a prickles. Clear? So that's an example of the species is the leaf spines like structures, the formation of this Sisyphus, that's an Indian palm. The last class we learned this species and Solanum trilobata. Okay, Solanum trilobata. So these are the species are the examples for the leaves are modified into spines. Then the next one is xerophytic. Some of the xerophytic plants also they are modified with the leaves or they modified into spines too, right? So that is one of the good example of this species of Opuntia. Okay, this one Catas varieties, the Opuntia, and another one more is Euphorbia. These all these items are they comes under the Catas variety, children. So that is a good examples for this xerophytic plants, Opuntia and Euphorbia. So they presents in the stipule part. Okay, that's a stipule, so they modified into leaf spines like structures. Understood? The next one is water sprinkles. Okay, water sprinkles, children. Very good. What is the characters? What is the nature of the prickles? Do you know? Very good. Very small and sharp like structures. Am I correct? So that is the like structures they developing from the epidermal cells. Okay, that small outgrowths they presents or produce or arises from the epidermal cells of the stem region or it may be leaf region also. Okay. So this one, what is the major use of the prickles means? The scrambling over the plants. Okay, the scrambling over the plant, that's a major duty for helping this prickles, the presence in the leaf. Clear, children? So then also sometimes the grazing of this animals, you know, that's a herbivores. So that time they giving in a protection, okay, so against that herbivores. So that's the concept, they giving in a protection. So this are the modification. So this is the modification only, they presents in a prickers. That's a very good example of the species is the rosa species. Understood, ma'am?
Yes.
Next one is storage leaves. Storaging of leaves. Certain leaves are they modified in the storage. Storage leaves, can you able to quote some of these examples, children? Storage leaves. Very good. Olivora, agave, bryophyllum. So these are the very good examples of the storaging of the leaves. Probably what is the nature of the storage leaf? Very good. So that's the nature of the leaf is. So that's a fleshy and swollen leaves are present. That's a very succulent in nature. Am I correct? So they are storing of a more water content, and then their presence in a mucilaginous tissues, mucilaginous, and also their presence in a food materials. All these items are they storing concept that leaves are their presence in a succulent or fleshy in nature. Okay, fleshy and a swollen type of the leaf is present. Understood, ma? Yes. So mainly. So this is the examples they are given, that's a olivora, agave and bryophyllum species. Understood? Yes. Next one is the leaf looks modified into phyllode. Okay, that's a phyllode. What does mean by phyllode means? So here that's a flat green, and so this one, okay, that's a flat green. So that's a area, that's a leaf area that is modifying, that's a petiole and a rachis region. Okay, that's a petiole or rachis regions, they modifying a phyllode. Okay, that's a modification of the petiole or that's a rachis regions only they modify, just to look like a flat and green and thin like natures. Understood, children? This leaf lamina or that's a leaflet. So there is, they comes under in a caducus. Caducus means, so that's a leaves are immediately follow this after formation of this one. Okay, the caducus we are going to learn, that's a detail in this leaf duration, children. How only that's a leaf duration is present. So later we will learn that's a detail. But first of all, that's a phyllodelate. What is phyllodelate? What, which one leaf region is they modified into phyllode, children? Then what is the example of this phyllode? The example of the phyllode is, first of all, this is the example is Acacia and Parkinsonia. Okay, so these are the two species they are comes under in that. What is the example? Phyllode. Okay, so this one, petiole or rachis region, this modified in here. Flat green like structures. So this one only they are doing in this all the duties of the leaf. Clear, children? Yes. Next one is we are going to learn about in a pitcher plant. So already you learned this one from the lower class itself. You learn about this is the pitcher plants. Anyway, so here also they are given that the leaf is modified into pitcher plants. Which areas is they modified into leaf pitcher plants, children? Which one is they modified? Very good. Which one? Leaf. Very good. Metripopus portion. Okay, that's the leaf metrip regions only. They presence in a coiled like structures. Then this is the picture is vertically standing. Okay, so that's a vertically. So the runners they. So just holding this picture, that's vertically, that's the things only, the metripopus leaf, that's a leaf lamina, metrip region, that's metrip only, they presence in a coiled like structures, or that's coiled or tendril like structures. Understood, ma? Yes, that's a good, we want an example of this picture plant, that's the example of the species is Nepenthes. Okay, that's a picture of the plant is Nepenthes. If we are looking this Nepenthes plant, so here, finally, the apical part, there one lid-like structure is there, no? One lid-like structure is there, no? So that one is the leaf apex part. Okay, that's a leaf tip regions only, that one is they modify, they closed just like a picture lid-like structures. Understood? The picture, that's the latest, the modification of which one? Leaf tip regions. Understood, ma? Yes. Next one is, we are going to learn about it's a bladder. Clear? So next one is we are going to learn about in a bladder. So here One of this very good example of the species is Utricularia. Okay, one of this good example of the species is Utricularia. So that is called, that name is known as bladed worm. So here, the rootless, free floating are slightly, we are telling in a submerged plants. Okay, so this is the many water bodies only they present in this type of the plant species, children. So that's water bodies. So they are present in a very good one of this very rootless, free floating, slightly, that is, they come under the nature of submerged plants. So they are very, that's a good segments. So that's a segment for they modifying in a bladder like structures. Okay, but that is a dissected like leaf is there. That leaf segments, okay, that's a leaf segment is just to form a bladder like structures. Understood, ma'am? So what is the major duty for this one means? So that one is the dropping of this insect. Okay, that's aquatic aquatic animals or that just like aquatic insects are there now. So that one is the catching purpose only. This so bladder like structure is present in the leaf. Clear, children? Yes. Next one is floral leaves. Floral leaves means a certain, what are the floral parts? What are the floral parts? Very good. Sepal, petal, stamen, carpels. Am I correct? So these all the parts are we are telling in a floral leaves. Isn't it, children? Yes. So these floral buds are, they are modified. The floral buds are, they are modified in the leaves. So first of all, the sepal and the petals are, they just like a leaf-like structures. They're giving in a protection, that's giving in that's a protection function. Very good. And next of all, so that is they giving in a, they are comes under in a non-essential reproductive part. Petal and sepals are, they comes under in a non-essential floral parts. Am I correct? Then that's a petals means sometimes so they modify in a colored type children. So that is the major duty. Very good. Attracting that insect for pollination purpose. Clear? Then the stamens. The stamens means, so that one is the bearing in a microsporophylls. Okay? But the pollen they bears in a microsporophylls. That is the adaptation. That is the modification as they across in a stamens. Carpels means the ovules they bearing in a megasporophylls. Okay, the megasporophyll, microsporophyll, already you learned now. So that is the same answer. They are pollen bears microsporophyll and the carpels means that's the ovule bears megasporophyll. Clear, children? So these are the certain modification they present in the floral leaves. So sepal, petal, stamens, carpels. So these are the items they modify in itself. Comes under the, that modification of the leaves, we are called as a floral leaf modification. Understood, ma? Yes. Next one is leaf duration. Last one more, that's one of the small portion, children. Leaf duration. So here, the leaves are how many days or that's how many years they are staying in that leaf. So that means they are giving in a leaf duration. Leaf duration means how many days are remaining, how many years are remaining. So this is the concept only they are telling in, that's a leaf duration. Based on that, the leaf folding of the leaf or it remains remaining in the leaf. So that means they are divided into four types, children. One is caducus, deciduous, evergreen and marsen. Clear? But what are the four types of this leaf duration? First one is caducus means very falling off very soon after formation. The leaf is formed, immediately they fall off this leaf. Okay, so that is we are called as a caducus type. Very good example of the species is Opuntia and the Sizes quadrangularis. The Sizes quadrangularis, that's a common name, is already I taught this one. Do you remember that? Very good. Parenting, clear? Opuntia and the Sizes quadrangularis. Then deciduous. Deciduous means, so here the ending of this season, okay, that's a growing season, the end is, that's a plant is, that's the falling of the leaf. clear children? That's maybe trees like plants, or maybe shrubs like plants. Anyway, on the winter or summer season, the falling of the leaves. Okay, so that's a leaf type which we are called, that's a deciduous type. Understood children? That's an example of the species maple, plumelia and erythenia. So these are the species they comes under in a deciduous type of this leaf decoration. Evergreen means throughout the year the leaves are regularly very good persist of this leaf. So that's the trees, that is the never, that's the leaf litter going on. Understood? So that is the evergreen leaf, always they present that leaf. Okay, that's the Calophyllum and Mimus. So these are the species examples of evergreen. Then mossy leaf means the leaf not falling. Okay, so the leaves are not fall down children, but that is the withering of this leaf, wilting functions. Okay, so the leaves are not falling, but that's the wilting functions of the plant. So that type is we are called as a mossy type. Understood? That's a good example of this. So family name is a Fagaceae. That's the family name is, they comes under in a Fagaceae. Clear? But first of all, so today's class we learned that's a 2 5-mark question children. Very important to 2 5-mark question. First one is the modification of the leaf, and another one is very good leaf type. Okay, in sometimes they will ask, that's the compound leaf. It explains the compound leaf. So at that time you have to be right, that's a pinnately compound leaf and a palmately compound leaf. That's very important one of the 5-mark question. And another one more question is the modification of the leaves. Okay, sometimes this is the leaf duration, then maybe ask that 2-mark question, or sometimes this also asking in a 5-mark practice. Understood children? Please all of you prepare your daily portion thoroughly children. So all of you learn well. Okay, thank you students.